What happened? Why don't you ask him?
Go on, take me to jail, copper.
Jail?
We'll be sure to send your regards.
The attacks were strategically brilliant.
Obviously by someone who knows us very well.
The plans were mine. I've carefully studied every Justice Leaguer, past and present, and created contingency plans to neutralize you. My actions don't require any defense. In the same situation, I'd do it again. The Justice League is far too dangerous to lack a failsafe against any possible misuse of our power.
You made contingency plans to stop everybody in the League. You're still so arrogant, you didn't bother to come up with a plan to stop yourself.
I do have a plan. It's called the Justice League.
Over the years, the DC Animated Universe has achieved a certain level of perfection which the DC Extended Universe could never reach.
That's where you made your mistake.
What Marvel did with its cinematic universe, DC has been doing that for a long time with its animated movies. Recently released Justice League Dark Apocalypse War was the final installment to the DCAU, which started with Justice League War in 2014, and it was an ending we deserved. It was dark, gory, and debaucherous in all the ways possible. With this, we faced the end of an era, and so we visited all the 38 releases in the DC Universe original movie series and chose the 5 most important Justice League animated movies that shaped the DCAU. We have selected movies where the entire team or at least more than 2 members are involved. So even if we love Batman solo animated movies with The Dark Knight Returns and Mask of the Phantasm being our favorites, we have not included them in today's list. And we at About Flick believe that as comic book aficionados, it is not only wrong but treacherous to rank these movies.
Boo.
So we're just naming the top 5 Justice League animated movies in chronological order. The Justice League are no strangers to alternate dimensions.
You're going to find what I have to say very difficult to believe.
You're from a parallel Earth.
How could you possibly know that?
An adaptation of the comics Crisis on Earth 3 and JLA Earth 2, the animated adventure Crisis on 2 Earth sees our Earth Prime heroes go up against their evil Earth 3 doppelgangers, the Crime Syndicate. Aided and warned by the heroic Earth 3 Lex Luthor, the Earth Prime JLA must combat the evil Syndicate on both worlds. This film not only gives us a faithful interpretation of the infamous Crime Syndicate, but also gives us a JLA who are well established and well coordinated. While none of the major voice actors associated with Warner Bros. Animated Universe lend their talents here, the film is still a great entry into their animated library of films. The film also stands above some others thanks to the final showdown between Batman and Owlman.
But when it looked back at us, you blinked.
The film shows just how far Batman is willing to go to protect the planet. Doom takes us for an action-packed roller coaster ride as we see Batman struggle with the fact that his plans are being used to harm those closest to him.
Justice League is under attack.
By whom?
By me!
Doom was one of the last projects Dwayne McDuffie worked on before his tragic passing, and it was one of his best. The film features the same great dialogue and character dynamics that make McDuffie one of the best in the business.
If you people can't see the potential danger of an out-of-control Justice League, I don't belong here.
On top of that, we got most of the voice talent from the critically acclaimed Justice League and Justice League Unlimited shows, with an extra bump from Nerd King Nathan Fillion as Hal Jordan.
I want a lawyer.
You're getting ahead of yourself. First you want a doctor.
Moreover, the use of classic villains like Vandal Savage, the mastermind behind the whole operation, as well as several other known baddies like Bane, Metallo, and Stars of Fire made Doom stand out as a fast-paced thriller.
You've all tried and failed to kill members of the League on multiple occasions.
Savage has foolproof plans for how we can destroy them.
No wonder you wanted us out of the way.
I thought you took care of him!
Don't feel bad. Actually, none of you managed to finish the job. Did you get all that?
We did.
Justice League The Flashpoint Paradox is one of the darkest films that DC has ever made, period. An adaptation of the Flashpoint storyline, Flashpoint Paradox does a tremendous job of telling the story of Barry Allen, aka The Flash, and his efforts to reset the timeline after causing untold damage by going back in time to save his mother in the past. We follow Barry as he tries to navigate his way through this different universe and help with the conflicts burdening the new world he's found himself in. The Flashpoint world has been torn apart by a war between Atlantis led by Aquaman and the Amazons led by Wonder Woman, As Cyborg, the world's premier superhero, tries to form his own ragtag Justice League and appoint Thomas Wayne, who is the present Batman, in the new timeline. Barry's arch-nemesis, the Reverse Flash, also plays a particularly evil role in the events that unfold.
As long as I can siphon off the Speed Force, you can't escape this timeline.
There is now. The only way to save the world is to keep this world from ever happening.
A highly emotional storyline, we see Barry deal with the weight of his history-altering decisions as he tries to undo his mistakes, leading up to an ending that brings a tear to the eye of the Dark Knight himself.
You're one hell of a messenger.
Like the comic it's based on, this movie is a bleaker version of the DC Universe. It all leads to a final act that will make you wonder how this film got away with a PG-13 rating. It may go a little too far with this violent final battle, but it's still one heck of a flick.
Good job, Barry. The world is about to end thanks to you.
When Bruce Timm, the creator of the 1992 Batman animated series, produced a standalone Justice League Elseworlds story, we the ardent fans knew that it was a must-watch. Gods and Monsters drastically changes the Justice League members not only in appearance and voice acting, but in origin as well. We see a Superman who was raised by Mexican immigrants and also happens to be the son of General Zod.
If anyone's seed is going to be spread to the heavens, it will be mine.
Batman as a vampiric scientist named Kirk Langstrom, and Wonder Woman as a new god from the now peaceful apocalypse. Though major changes were made to the characters' origins, their personalities and actions are strictly reminiscent of their more mainstream depictions. One of the most explicit and mature animated stories told by DC, Gods and Monsters is a violent and sexy tale of the Justice Leaguers being framed by an unknown enemy. Struggling with societal acceptance, unchecked power, and a frame job pinning several murders on the members, this version of DC's Trinity has extremely different ways of handling issues than the Justice League we know and love. The film definitely pushed the boundaries of animated storytelling, even for the already mature DC.
If only she hadn't wanted you, who only loved your bats and test tubes.
Wrong. I loved two people in my life, and now they're both gone.
It's funny how things can change so quickly. Forgive me, Kirk.
And although we loved the new Superman and Human Bat, it was Wonder Woman we had fallen in love with after watching this flick.
I belong to no man, not Superman, not you.
No points for guessing, guys. This movie was dark, gory, debaucherous, and a whole shebang that the DCAU stood for. It justifiably got the R rating. The fact that an early clip for Justice League Dark Apocalypse War had gone viral for stating that John Constantine got intimate with King Shark says quite a lot about this movie in general. Warner Bros. Definitely never going to make the Snyder sequel with a Darkseid ravaged future Earth, but this might be the next best thing. With the apocalyptic end of the world scenario, when we got Constantine as the linchpin, we knew things would get bloodier and uglier, and it did. Viewers should prepare themselves for a level of violence that borders on the ridiculous. The fight scenes are intense and often thrilling, but there's a level of gore to some of these scenes that serves no purpose other than allowing DC to flaunt the movie's R rating. The advantage of this being the last movie in the long-running series is that there's a much greater level of storytelling freedom. Apocalypse War is free to break as many DC toys as it wants without a fear of what that means for the future spin-offs or sequels. And break it certainly does.
Go to hell.
Superman's characterization in particular is a bit off compared to where we last saw him in Reign of the Superman, but this was always a common criticism of the New 52 comics themselves, that too many characters were given pointless, edgy overhauls in the name of appealing to young readers. At least Apocalypse War finds ways of justifying the sometimes extreme character changes. While Jason Momoa shines in this flick, which might be his last time wearing the cape and cowl, it was Matt Ryan who stole the entire show as Constantine.
It can't even be a corpse in peace.
Holy shit, he's alive!
Wanking destiny can go bugger itself. Still pissed at you.
Comic book lovers are going to talk about this movie for years.
You know what you have to do, mate.
Another flashpoint.
So I guess that wraps it up. What do you guys think? Did I miss any that you think should be on the list? Let me know in the comments below.
Let's get the hell out of here.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Click on the little bell icon to be notified whenever a new one comes out. Don't forget to share this video with your friends. I'll see you guys next time.